Our story began at the Astral Academy, the highest place of wizardly learning in all the kingdom. The Academy housed magical secrets in its vaults, and the wizards had vowed to protect them from falling into the wrong hands. A fiercely persistent monster had set its mind upon penetrating the fragments.
How odd. The monster is immune to our magic.
With all these recent incidents around the Academy, I'm beginning to think we need outside assistance.
I will be free.
Let's send for help. What we need is our heroes.
With trouble in the kingdom, who could save the day? Why, of course, the three heroes of our story, Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya. At that time, Pontius, a stout-hearted knight and protector of the common folk, was busy at work. He was tracking a thief who had abducted a sheep from a poor peasant family.
A no-good bandit is hiding somewhere in these ravines. I'll catch him and save that sheep, or my name isn't Pontius the Brave. Release the sheep, and I'll let you down, you thieving blackguard! He won't be getting away! Blasted thief! That poor sheep is about to end up as goblin grub. If you don't do something. Fork and dinner knife. This sheep is going back home with me. The end of them. Let's set you free.
While Pontius was the strongest and bravest of them all, Zoya was another matter entirely. Zoya had been a thief long before circumstances had made her a reluctant hero. In the recent years, though, Zoya had less interested in burgling the largesse of high society. Instead, she directed her attentions abroad, to far distant lands, their old forgotten ruins and treasures.
My prize at last. I usually like animals, but I could make an exception with this parrot.
Thank you.
finally. What was that?
The last of our three heroes was Amadeus. As a young man, he dreamed of becoming a powerful sorcerer. You know, Amadeus the wizard was enjoying a well-deserved holiday to see migrating giant turtles with his wife Margaret and their three children. The wizard's wife was a firebrand of a woman, and all their three children were very talented when it came to conjuring fireballs. In fact, it was a small blessing that one afternoon they had left poor Amadeus to have a nap in peace. But he slept too long. When he woke up, he was already late to see the great turtles.
I'm late. Oh, I'm so late. Let's see if they went this way. Maybe, if I climb up on the cliffs, I could have a better view of the beach. I might find the turtles as well as Margaret and the children. This skull gate is securely locked, but I want to get in.
magnificent view. And there are the turtles, on their way to make more turtles, I suppose. The artifact of soul. How nice of you to join me. Thank you again for all the magic powers you've bestowed on me, and all the marvelous adventures. If you're here about business, I'm sorry, but I'm unable to join you. You see, this is the first time I've ever been on holiday with my family since you and I first met. Please?
Oh, it's Tri. Can you wait a little? I still need to return this sheep to its family.
Oh, your timing is extremely inconvenient. Well, Travis.
It was not unusual that our three heroes would be whisked away at a moment's notice, for with great power came also great responsibility. The artifact of soul had arcane powers of resurrection, making our three heroes immortal and capable of great deeds and adventures. Sometimes, whether the heroes wanted these adventures or not.
I still don't understand how this Trine magic works.
You see, when we are together, the artifact contains our real selves, and our outside selves are projections. Like...
It's a bit tiresome to put all your life on hold because of a magical candle stand with a flair for abducting bystanders for adventures.
I was in the middle of a daring rescue myself.
We seem to be at the outskirts of the Astral Academy.
This isn't a good place for an adventure. I've already pinched everything.
A water course, of course.
To the Astral Academy go through a lily pond.
Landscaping isn't really a part of the curriculum.
Since we're here and all, better do something about it.
Defeated monster, soon scattering and fading into the wind.
Smokes of vile sorceries!
Look here! This villain, it's made of junk.
Creepy. How's this for an idea? If we all give Trine back its powers, we could go back to living our lives as free and normal people.
Freedom. It does sound tempting.
The heroes had gained their strange powers in the first place by touching the artifact, and so they reached out to it again.
I don't think it's working.
Imagine giving away your powers.
How about I imagine sticking an arrow through this busy... Turned out worse than I could have imagined.
It's headed for the academy.
All right, that makes it a little worse. And I guess that means...
We're going to follow it!
Possession of the roots.
Let's see if they fall as easily as the big one.
To hear Zoya scream when the artifact broke.
Wait, what? You must be talking about Amadeus.
I made no such sound.
Well, if neither of you screamed, who was it?
So many days spent fishing, and nothing to show for it. What bad luck.
Thank you.
At last, there will be fish stew for dinner.
More wizard landscaping?
I'm sure they had something practical in mind when they set these up.
You went along with us in trying to return things back to normal. But I don't get it. Why would Pontius the Brave voluntarily give up his magic powers?
I've been starting to think trying is a little unfair when it comes to prioritizing our adventures between the socio-economic classes.
Huh? What?
We're always rescuing kings and princesses. What about the sheep?
Thank you.
It looks like this tiny shard of Trine gives us some of our old power.
Keep it safe, Amadeus. I have a hunch we're going to need it when we track down that dark cloud.
Onwards!
Amadeus, Pontius and Zoya's retirement plans had gone horribly wrong. Instead of getting rid of their extraordinary powers, the heroes entered the Astral Academy with the intention of finding out where the sinister cloud of darkness was headed.
Ours was just one of three artifacts, right? There's the artifact of body and the artifact of mind, too.
Yes, and they're both stored in the Academy's vaults. And are far less lively than our artifact of soul. Hey.
What are the three artifacts, Amadeus?
I know as much as any wizard. They're three magical containers found in dwarven ruins years ago. Very few people have ever been able to tap into their power.
Who made the artifacts?
No one knows for sure. They thought it was the dwarves, but it's not likely, since they don't resemble anything else the dwarves made. I have a hunch we should go to the vault where the other two artifacts are stored. The black cloud might be headed there. Possessing the Academy.
Understood, you uppity trinkets!
Let's hope they die as soon as they come to life.
Thank you.
office of the old king. When the old king left...
There's a whole stash of books here about the artifacts. And about us, since we've been stuck with one of them for the past few years.
I hope they mention my red cloak.
What? Someone's written about me? With whose permission?
Studying the artifacts of power.
Sharp metal parts. Better be careful.
Thank you.
So, is it actually a good idea to follow the black possessive smoke around the academy?
You're the wizard. You should know these things.
A possessed room.
Tear it apart!
Which one's this?
That's the artifact of body. There seems to be an order here.
The third artifact of power was in the last port. Sinister energies swept inside it, and then it exploded.
I'm free!
So good to meet you three properly at last. I am Sarek the Deathless. Thank you for helping me get out of these ridiculous prisons. 1,000 years I've been torn apart.
Wait. Were you inside the Artifact of Soul all these years, helping us?
Merely a small part of me. You confused me with my jailer, whose torturous scream so pierced the air when her vessel of power was torn apart. But I must thank you three again for getting rid of her so efficiently.
We did no such thing!
You meddled with powers beyond your understanding. You wanted to be rid of her, break free, and you got your heart's desire. Nothing destroys a soul better than a good old-fashioned betrayal. Alas, I must dash off and look for a comfortable body to occupy. Well, have a lovely day. Until we meet again.
Go to the library. Find the Chronicles of the Guardian.
Our tiny piece of the artifact spoke. It's alive.
And wants us to go to the library?
Any other requests, Miss Artifact?
But the voice emanating from the shard said nothing more.
mystery shiny things out there.
The other shards that broke off Trine.
And they're scattered all over the land. Nearest one seems to be in Redwood Forest.
Shouldn't we go pick them up?
I think we ought to do what the voice said and get to the library.
Hey!
That book doesn't normally glow like that. Something's amiss.
So, we'll take this enormous book and beat Sarek to death with it?
They do say the pen is mightier than the sword.
Aha. We'll use it to get information.
An unusual library book had kept...